And our final guest this morning in this run of insight, I suppose, economic and political commentator Bernard Hickey, who writes about economics and politics at thekaka.substack.com. Bernard, you've come into the studio. You're a lovely man. God, we so appreciate you. We know the impacts of this, don't we? We know it's homelessness, we know it's marginalisation, we know it's desperation, we know it's overcrowding, we know that people are losing hope. So let's put all of that on the record, because we've heard it over and over for years now, and say, what should the government, what must the government do today?
Well, they have to do something that changes this situation where we now have a landed gentry, where we have families who are landlords and families who are tenants, and they will never make that leap unless they marry into wealth. And that means the government has to do something substantial. Unfortunately, it has ruled out anything that really would make a difference. So the Prime Minister said a couple of years ago she would never tax capital gains in her political lifetime, and unless she's going soon, that is not going to change. I'd actually love to see the government bring in a simple, low land tax, which would immediately drop prices 10 to 20%. That's what was recommended actually in the first tax working group to John Key. He ruled it out.
Yeah.
And it did, unfortunately, we've seen Jacinda Ardern rule that out too before the last election. We may actually see something slightly like that. There is the suggestion there could be a tax on undeveloped housing land, and that would make some sort of difference, but not the transformative change we need. And the guts of it is the government has locked itself into a position where it targets the median voter, who's probably a homeowner, and has decided to back those homeowners by guaranteeing that prices won't fall. We keep asking, and that's the bottom line for the government. Prices cannot fall, even though they've risen 20% since the end of the lockdown.
Okay, so you talk about John Key and Jacinda Ardern ruling out the land tax, where the capital gains tax has been ruled out. Is there a political will to address this? I'm really interested to see David Parker is there this morning. He's the revenue minister, so clearly the government's planning to get some more money from somewhere. I presume this is an extension of the bright line test, but are you expecting any surprises, Bernard?
Well, I suspect the any tax on undeveloped land would really shake things up a bit. And secondly, the government could make it difficult for landlords to claim all of their interest costs as a taxable expense. Currently, there is a little rule out there for foreign-owned companies, which means that they can't claim all of their interest on loans from parents overseas. That so-called thin cap rule could be applied to landlords. That's a long shot, as is the land tax on undeveloped land, but those are somewhere within the bright lines or the red lines that the government has set out for itself with its various promises before the last election, and with Jacinda Ardern's bald never in my political lifetime.
No CGT. 30 seconds, otherwise I'll be in trouble. How desperate is this situation now, Bernard?
I cycled in here today, and again I saw people lying on a bench underneath the ninth floor of the Beehive, asleep, under blankets. I'm sick and tired of walking down the street and seeing so much homelessness. 22,000 families have registered as homeless. We heard this morning another young parent sleeping in cars. Mm. A lady in Wellington said yesterday she decided to buy a house bus because that was the only way she could get stable housing. This is a crisis. Mm. Why isn't it an emergency that needs every stone turned? Whereas the government has said we won't turn the debt stone and we won't turn the capital gains tax stone. Either you're governing for the long term for the people, or you're governing to get re-elected in 18 months. What is it?
Bernard Hickey, ending our sweep of commentators and would-be buyers. Thank you so much. We really appreciate it, Bernard. The government's announcement is at 9 o'clock. It's